"You surprise me," I said, "by these opinions which have been contradicted by the voice of the world. You do not mean to set at naught the well-digested idea of centuries. The mathematical reason has long been regarded as the reason par excellence."
"Il y a parière," replied Dupin, quoting from Chamfort, "que toute idée publique, toute conversion recoutest une sottise, car elle a convenu au plus grand nombre."
The mathematicians, I grant you, have done their best to promulgate the popular error to which you allude, and which is none the less an error, for its promulgation is truth. With an art worthy a better cause, for example, they have insinuated the term analysis into application to algebra. The French are the originators of this particular deception. But if a term is of any importance, if words derive any value from applicability, then analysis conveys algebra about as much as, in Latin, ambitus implies ambition, religio, religion, or homines honesti, a set of honorable men. "You have a quarrel on hand, I see," said I, "with some of the algebraists of Paris. But proceed."
"I dispute the availability, and thus the value of that reason which is cultivated in any especial form other than abstractly logical. I dispute, in particular, the reason adduced by mathematical study. The mathematics are the science of form and quantity. Mathematical reasoning is merely logic applied to observation upon form and quantity. The great error lies in supposing that even the truths of what is called pure algebra are abstract or general truths. And this error is so egregious that I am confounded at the universality with which it has been received. Mathematical axioms are not axioms of general truth. What is true of relation, of form and quantity, is often grossly false in regard to morals, for example. In this latter science, it is usually untrue that the aggregated parts are equal to the whole. In chemistry also, the axiom fails. In the consideration of motive it fails, for two motives, each of a given value, have not necessarily a value united equal to the sum of their values apart. There are numerous other mathematical truths which are only truths within the limits of relation. But the mathematician argues, from his finite truths through habit, as if they were of absolutely general applicability, as the world indeed imagines them to be.